will be God pleasers and not man.
Oh, yes.
Lord God, that we will enter into your gates with thanksgiving and with praise in our hearts. And Lord God, this is your day.
That's right.
This is the day that you have made. And we choose to rejoice and to be glad in it. We honor you and we reverence you and we give you thanksgiving because we could not do anything without your mercy, without your grace, and without your compassion. And so we say thank you to an omnipotent Father, to our Father, to a good Father, to an everlasting Father. Father God, bless this service as we dedicate our works to you. And Father God, bless the speaker of the hour. And Father God, we lift up a special prayer to those that are going through the spirit of infirmity. We give it in the name of Jesus. And Lord God, we just thank you for your healing power and influence. We love you today. And we praise and we bless your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus, Yeshua. Amen.
Amen.
Oh.
Our next item on the program.
which is often. God's been good to us, so surely we ought to respect that and give back.
Amen.
So at this time, if you can have an officer and an usher to come forth, please. We appreciate it.
I hear you, baby. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Sister Banks is so correct. We really don't need an introduction. He's become a part of our family as well as we have become a part of his. But nevertheless, he's the preacher of the hour, one I've come to love and admire. I love his spirit. And we just ask you, as he said, preacher, keep it short. I'll keep it short. You pray for me, I'll pray for you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So without no further ado, after selection, the next voice you hear will be on another than the preacher of the hour, Reverend Marc Green. Repeat out the name. Preacher.
Preacher.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
Preacher.
Preacher.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
Amen.
Thank you. So to Mattie Coleman, I want to say thank you so much. I don't take this lightly. And I want to be a good steward of your time. And I want to give you what you came for, which is the word. And to Lomax, thank you so much for continuing to support this second hour, this second push for the day. I promise I'm not going to keep you long. I'm going to tell you like Elizabeth Taylor told her eighth husband, I'm not going to keep you long. And she did. And she did. So I just want you to know, I'm definitely not going to keep you long. If you sleep, you're going to miss it. But I do believe there is a word from God today. And I want you to pray for me and pray for me that the Lord will speak to us for such a time as this. If you have your Bibles, I want you to turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 9, beginning at verse 6. I understand that this is Usher's Day, and we don't celebrate the ushers, but the Lord gave me something to tell everybody this afternoon. And I'm excited about what he's going to say. Anytime you get to preaching, you say, because he's going to tell me something in this. But 2 Corinthians chapter 9, beginning at verse 6.
All right.
And when you get there, just come on and say with me, amen.
Amen.
2 Corinthians, chapter 9, verse 6. So when you get there, what you'll find are these words. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. We're going to stop right there. Man. If you just pray real hard, I promise, I'll preach real short. If you just pray real, real hard, I'll preach. I feel somebody already in the spirit. Just pray. So we're going to pray. So let's go together. And if you don't mind, just give me just a second. Bow your heads with me. Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. Let my soul look up with a steadfast hope, and my will be lost in thine. Father, I ask that you grant that anointing that makes preaching easy. That God, you use me in spite of me, that your name be glorified and your people be edified in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
For just a very few moments, I want to talk to you from the attitude of the giver. Can we just talk like we know each other real well this afternoon? You know, when we look at this text, most of us, if not all of us, ascribe these few verses to giving tithes and offerings.
All right.
That when we look at this, we look at the process of sowing and reaping. Mm-hmm. We look at the giving, and we see that God loves a cheerful giver, and we begin to fashion in our minds that God has told us that this is about giving money. Beloved, it is about giving, but for a moment, I just want to set your theology aside and set your doctrine aside. And just for one moment, I want you to look at this thing from the perspective of stewardship.
All right.
And not just any stewardship. I want to be specific. I want you to look at this thing in the concept of time. I want you to look at this not in money, but in time. Because you know the most valuable thing we have, Brother Gaius, is not money, but it's time.
That's right.
The most valuable thing that we have to give to God is not what's in our pockets or purses, but in our hands. I want to share with you that if if you look at this thing from the perspective of time, it changes the whole paradigm of what we're going to talk about this afternoon. I want to talk to you from the thought of time, that God loves a cheerful giver of their time.
Some of your time.
wonder why your life is not blessed, beloved. It's because that offering of time that you give him is not with the right attitude. We give him mad time to God. You mad cause you got to be here. You mad in your song. You mad in your worship. You mad in your preaching. You mad in your giving. And then you want to ask God to bless you. You done come in here with an attitude already. Mad cause you got to be. But he says, don't come in to give me some time. Don't be a giver of grudging. He says, don't give me your time out of necessity.
Come on.
Oh, out of necessity, out of need, that you come here because you need something from God. You give your time because you think it's on a barter system, that the more time you give to God, the more he's going to bless you. So you don't come here out of no other reason than you feel like you need something from God. So you come here and we give God our time because we need him to bless us. So we go the extra mile, and we go the extra minute, and we give extra prayers, and we give extra offerings because we need a blessing from God. And I'm here to tell you that it does not work like that. That you can't put God on a give and take system. You can't say, if I give you this, will you give me that? The barter system does not work with God. So no matter what you say, no matter what you give, because you need something from God, it will not bless you. He says he loves a cheerful giver of your time. That when you come into the house, you are cheerful to be here. You are glad to be here. That God allowed you the privilege of coming into his house one more time. You're excited that God has blessed you to see this day, and you want to return some thanks for God being so good to you. So you may not have a lot of money, but what you do have is time, and you give your time to God out of a cheerful heart. It is the attitude of the giver that matters to God. We say that every Sunday. It's not what you give, it's the attitude in which you give. It's not what you give, it's how you give it. So don't be mad that you have to be here. That don't be mad because you feel like that it's your committee and you have to be here. And don't feel upset because someone done talked you into being on usher board number 5 and you sitting at the door mad and upset because you have to be here. Let me tell you, baby, that God honors those that stand at the door and watch and greet the believers of God. Don't you be upset and give God your time because God won't bless you.
Bring it, brother. Bring it.
It's the attitude in which you give. And when you have a good attitude of giving, God makes grace abound towards you. Look at verse 8. He says, and God is able to make all grace abound towards you. God gives you grace when you have a good attitude of giving. And grace says you get some stuff that you really don't deserve. All that God begins to bless you with things that you really don't deserve. And you wonder how people look at you and say, how did you get those things? Baby, it's grace. And they say, where does grace start? It starts with my attitude. It starts with that. I'm just glad to be in the, you know, when we were younger and the old folk used to sing, just glad to be in the service. One more time. Didn't have to let me live, but I'm just glad to be offering good work. What he's really trying to say is, I'm going to bless your hand. That baby, everything you touch is going to turn to gold. That the work that you do, I'm going to put you in the overflow. That when you have an attitude of giving, I will put you in the overflow. That people will wonder why you're so blessed. It's because your attitude is right and how you give to God. So beloved, before I take my seat, before I leave you right here, you can be in the church from sun up to sundown and still not be blessed. You can be in every church service, every revival. You can be in every city and still not be blessed. Oh, you can give all your money to you broke, busted, and disgusted and still not be blessed.
Trepidation,
they were all afraid. The stewards and the trustees you. And it's the attitude of the giver that matters the most to God. God, I don't have anything else. I don't have a dime in my pocket. But the best thing I can give you, the best thing I can give you is me. That's it in a nutshell. The best thing that I can give you. So every time I give you me, I'm going to give it with the best attitude that I have to give. Every time I come in here, I'm giving you me as an offering. Every time I come into this place, I'm giving you myself as an offering. So God, change my heart, change my mind, that my attitude will have an attitude of gratitude when I come into this service. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Thank you. Amen. And this is one day I'm glad I had it on record.
Amen.
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 Amen. I don't know if he's talking to Lomax, but you sure talk to Mattie E.
Amen.
Amen.
Only what we give. Thank you. That's not that.
Thank you.
If we can't change our hearts after today, really, ain't nothing God can do for you.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Attitudes. You know, us have got some bad attitudes, too. We church folk, ain't no sense of lying in church.
Know you right.
Ask you to do something, you buck up, get somebody else.
You know you right.
And when we don't ask, you mad about that. Thank you, preacher. We needed that.
Help us, Lord. And mercy.
Attitude. I want to be blessed.
Yes.
Matter of fact, I want to be more than blessed. I want to be blessed with my time that I can bless somebody else with my time. So when my time is gone, they still can be blessed with somebody else. That's an overflow.
Yes.
Thank you. Can I play this Sunday morning? Thank you. Get me off the program now. Like my dad, I forgot what I'm up here for. Choir, can y'all give us a cool down? Can y'all give us a selection? Put us back in perspective. As I open the doors of the church before they sing, can we stand? Maybe one today.
Oh, Jesus,
today is a good day. We have time. It's for a song that maybe one today. Us.
Amen.
Thank you, preachers. God don't need our money.
Mighty, mighty.
He'll give it to us. He don't need our homes. He built it for us. So why do we think? Why do we think we can come to church and do what God has we please?
Praise it down.
Thank you, preacher. I like that.
Thank you, Lord.
As we come to the close of the program, there'll be an announcement. Sister Banks, you have anything else? I want to thank you for your service. And I want to say this, when God asks you to do something, do it. Don't get mad because man asks you to do something for God. We are God's workmanship.
Great to that.
You know, all the time that you could have, that you didn't. Wouldn't it be something God treated us like we treat him? I want to thank the Ushers for today.
Praise
our president in the back, Sister Jewel, you have any comments? Last remarks?
The members of Lomax Temple for coming today and sharing the Usher Day program. And we was really inspired by Reverend Green's message. Amen. We're going to take it with us and think about it. And it was a great, great message. And I want to thank all the congregation, the Mattie Coleman ushers, and the ushers that's from Lomax Temple. So I would like to thank you, and may God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. As the preacher give us the benediction, we ask for Esther to do well. Freshness for you in the back. We ask that our guests be seated first. We're going to fellowship without an attitude. We're going to hear and he'll be happy today, amen. Y'all all right? Amen. I want to leave this question with you. I'm doing it because our professors keep telling us to say it. Did our leadership corrupt the church? Did the church corrupt the leadership? Think about that. Does leadership corrupt the church? Or does the church corrupt leadership? And I guess I'll leave that with you. Pastor, you may come. Just listen to me all the way. Thank you, choir. Amen. 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 Now, often you get to see a little bit of white get back and just sing their hearts out of it. Amen. Amen. I want to say thank you to the choir, too, and those of you who are so faithful. I believe with all my heart God honors faithfulness.
Yes. Yes.
With all my heart,
his
faithfulness that matters to God. Because he's faithful to us. Amen. He's faithful to us. And I thank you for making time to be here. Because you had to make time to be here. You didn't have to be here. But you made time. You put this in your schedule to be here. And when you make time for God, beloved, he blesses you. So again, I want to just leave you with saying, whatever you do for God, make sure you do it with a cheerful heart. It is the attitude of the giver that matters the most. Again, thank you, ushers, for coming out.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lomax. Thank you, Mattie Coleman. Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah.
See, it doesn't take a whole lot of people. And guess what? It doesn't take a whole lot of time. So whatever we give to God, as long as we honor him with our cheerfulness, he will bless it. Amen. If all hearts and minds are clear. To my pastor, my friend, thank you so much for allowing me to be here. And all of you, God's people, if all hearts and minds are clear, let us give the benediction. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his throne with exceedingly great joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Both now and forever, may all of God's people say amen.
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 Before we leave, I don't want to forget, and as I was saying, the benediction to my beloved, sweet, kind, gentle woman who cooked me into the shape that I'm in now, my beloved mother, for being here. She's here this afternoon today. I want to thank you, Mama. Thank you for coming. All of you, God's children, again, God bless you. God keep you. Have a great rest of the day.
Amen.
Praise God.